We're going to turn this into this. Let's get started. I'll start off with this image in our composition. I'm going to be going through a process where we only glitch a certain part of an image. Make sure your image is in raster mode rather than a smart object. And I can do this by making sure that the object doesn't have this icon on it. If it does, right-click on the layer and select Rasterize, or double-click on the layer. Firstly, I'll duplicate this layer by right-clicking and selecting Duplicate. I'll rename this Background 2. I'll then go over to the left-hand side and select the Quick Selection tool, before dragging a shape around our object to make sure that our foreground object is all selected. I've chosen this particular image as the target object is partially obscured, but I'll see in just a moment that it doesn't really matter. Then it's a case of clicking Select and Mask, adjusting the radius and smoothing a little, and then selecting OK. I'll then press Ctrl or Command C to copy the selected portion of this layer, then hold Shift whilst pressing Ctrl or Command V to paste it in exactly the same place. Our new layer will appear on the right-hand side, and I'll just quickly disable all of the other layers to check for integrity of our cutout. Now this looks good, but if you do make mistakes, for example, part of the image isn't selected, just press Ctrl or Command Z until you get back to the selection tool, and there you can add selections whilst holding Shift, and also remove them whilst holding Alt. Now we're going to begin layering glitchy effects onto the cutout part of the image. Firstly, let's re-enable the other layers so that we can see the effects on the main image, and duplicate the cutout image by right-clicking and selecting Duplicate. Selecting the top layer, I'll head over to Filter, Distort, and Wave. For the glitchy effect we're looking for, firstly, I'll change the type to square. Then I'll change the number of generators to 1, keep the wavelength between 50 and 350, which will define the range of the wave effect, and adjust the amplitude to between 250 and 400, which will change the intensity. We'll then change the horizontal scale to 5% and the vertical scale to 1%, meaning the element will be biased to affecting horizontal scale. The difficulty about such a small preview window and no real-time previewing means that you have to apply changes to see if your effect is good enough, but it's easy enough to experiment. You can click Randomize a couple of times till you see a nice glitchy look, and then once we've hit OK, we can see that it's applied a long blocky effect to the layer, but it hasn't affected the background since we've applied it to the cutout object. Change the blending mode to luminosity for this layer, and hide it using the eye icon. We need to add the same effect to the layer below, so I'll go to Filter, Distort, and Wave, and then using the same options, hit Randomize until we see a different looking effect. Once I click OK and it looks good, we can re-enable the top layer. Right-click it and select Blending Options. Then we can disable the green and blue channels in the Advanced Blending section by unchecking the G and B boxes, leaving only the red channel enabled. This is what we're looking for, the aberration of red and blue, which are a traditional glitch style. Now do the same for the other layer. Our next step is to add a grungy glitch effect above the other two layers. Select the top layer and duplicate it. Then go back to Filter, Distort, and Wave. We now want to increase the intensity of the effect, so I'm going to adjust the wavelength to 24 and 25, our amplitude to 1 and 100, and dial up our horizontal scale all the way to 100%. I'll hit Randomize a few times, and then hit OK. Next, I'll select these top three layers by holding Shift and clicking on each one. Then right-click and duplicate them. Of these six layers, I'll select the bottom three and press Ctrl or Command G to group them. Then I'll drag the background 2 layer below the top three layers. Select them, right click, and merge. I'll duplicate the layer twice so there are three of the same layer. Select the Marquee tool, then click on the top layer and make a thin and wide rectangle. You can then hold Shift to add more. Then click the Mask button, which is a white rectangle with a dot in the middle. Make sure at least one of the layers includes a decent amount of background as it adds to the depth of the glitch effect. It really depends on the look you're going for, but smaller and thinner strips usually look better. I'll do the same for the other two layers. And after they're all selected and masked, press Ctrl or Command T, and then use the directional arrows of the cursor to move the layers in different directions off-center. This adds a data strip corruption look to the image. Select these top layers, then right-click and convert them to a smart object. Change the blending mode to color burn, then make the fill about 50% so it's more subtle. Then I'll place this layer below our group. To blend everything in nicely, I'm going to add a new layer by clicking on the plus button. On the new layer, I'm going to add a solid color, which I'll move to gray. Then I'll move over to filter, noise, and add noise. Making the amount 400%, I'll disable monochromatic so it generates color noise and hit OK. Then I'll make the blending mode vivid light and change the filter however intense you'd like the noise to be. There's endless extra effects you can add to this, so feel free to add some suggestions in the comments. Don't forget to drop us a like and subscribe for more content. Thanks for watching.